a lot of power today in this house. And something is going to happen. There is a spiritual motion in the house. So those who are in motions, and those who are emotions, it's not their fault. It's the presence of God in the house. Because we have confirmed
it
from our hearts.
That
is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Those things they did in the past.
It's
the same yesterday, today, and forever.
He
can do them today. He can do them tomorrow. He can do them forever.
He's
God who changes not. Times will change. Seasons will change. Men will change. Faith will change. But he changes not. He's faithful to his promises. What he promised to do, he's faithful to fulfill it. What he began in your life, he's faithful to accomplish it. Therefore, you cannot break what my father started doing in my life. No amount of trials, no amount of temptations that will bring into my ways. God promised to do something, and he's faithful to his word. What he said, he's going to fulfill it. He promised to lift me up from the dark and sit me with the prince. I've not seen that day, but I know, and I'm sure. And today, I know that what God said is coming to pass. I've never seen anywhere Satan stop the work of God. I've never seen where the devil destroyed the plans of God. He can introduce counterfeits. He can bring fake things. But fake things doesn't mean that there is no original. Counterfeit is a good sign that shows that there is real things that our Father has prepared for us. We are not going to faint. We are waiting upon the Lord. For the Bible says, those that wait upon the Lord shall mount up with wings like the eagles, and they shall not faint.
Turn with me to the book of Hebrews, chapter number 4, verse number 14, 15, and 16. The Bible says, seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heaven, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast to our convention.
Basi iwapo tunaye kuhani mkuu aliyeingia katika mbingu, Yesu mwana wa Mungu, tuyashike sana maungamano yetu.
For we do not have an high priest who cannot sympathize with our weakness, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin.
Kwa kuwa hamna kuhani mkuu asiyeweza kuchukuana nasi katika mambo yetu ya udhaifu, bali yeye aliyejaribiwa sawa sawa na sisi katika mambo yote bila kufanya dhambi.
Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help us in time of need.
Basi tukaribie kiti cha neema kwa ujasiri, ili tupewe rehema na kupata neema ya kutusaidia wakati wa mahitaji.
We are going to exhaust that scripture today.
Tunaenda kumaliza andiko hiyo siku ya leo.
And we need to get to understand what the Holy Spirit is trying to teach us in this church.
Na lazima tuweze kufahamu yale Roho Mtakatifu anajaribu kutufundisha katika kanisa hili.
When I began to read it, say seeing then that we have a great high priest
Ninapoanza kusoma inasema iwapo tunaye kuhani mkuu aliyeingia katika mbingu.
Who passed through the heavens?
Aliyeingia katika mbingu.
Jesus, the Son of God.
Yesu mwana wa Mungu.
Let us all fast to our confession.
Na tuyashike sana maungamano yetu.
This shows
inaonesha
that Jesus came in flesh to the earth.
Ya kwamba Yesu alikuja kwa mwili hapa duniani.
And he became like one of us.
Na akakuwa kama moja wetu.
And he lived like one of us.
Na akaishi kama moja wetu.
And he passed what some of us are passing through.
Na akapitia sawa sawa na kile wengi wetu wanapitia.
He had some feeling like some of us.
Alikuwa na hisia kama wengine wetu.
He was emotional.
Alikuwa na mihemuko.
He was just like anyone.
Alikuwa kama mtu yeyote yule.
He would laugh like anyone.
Angecheka kama yeyote.
That is part of emotions.
Hiyo ni sehemu ya mihemuko.
He would cry like anyone of us.
Angelia kama moja wetu.
That was part of emotions.
Hiyo ilikuwa sehemu ya mihemuko.
He was challenged.
Alipewa changamoto.
He passed through some circumstances.
Alipitia hali.
But he was like one of us.
Ya kwamba alikuwa kama moja wetu.
But the Bible says.
Lakini Biblia inasema.
He became the high priest.
Akafanyika kuhani mkuu.
And passed through the heavens.
Kapitia katika mbingu.
So the Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Let us hold for our first confession.
Tuweze kushika sana maungamano yetu ya kwanza.
What we confess to Christ.
Kile tuliungama kwa Kristo.
Or about him.
Ama kumuhusu Kristo.
Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
We should hold on fast.
Tunafaa kuyashika.
Without being shaken.
Bila kutingizwa.
Because he was tempted.
Kwa sababu alijaribiwa.
He passed through challenges.
Alipitia changamoto.
But he was not conquered.
Lakini hakushindwa.
He was not overcame.
Hakushindwa.
By those things.
Na mambo yale.
He overcame them.
Aliyashinda.
Though he had some feelings like yourself.
Ingawaje alikuwa na hisia kama wengine wetu.
He was criticized like you.
Aliweza kushawishiwa kama wengi wetu.
He was criticized.
Aliweza kudhihakiwa.
He was mocked.
Alidhihakiwa.
He was laughed at.
Alichekelewa.
But he overcame.
Lakini alishinda.
Praise be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa.
So if we hold our confession.
Tukishika sana maungamano yetu.
To him.
Kwake yeye.
That we know him.
Ambaye tunayemjua.
He did it.
Ya kwamba alishika.
He overcame.
Alishinda.
He passed through.
Alipitia.
Also some of us.
Hata wengine wetu.
Though we have those weakness.
Ingawaje tuna udhaifu.
We are going to overcome.
Tunaenda kushinda.
It doesn't care.
Haijalishi.
How my time it has taken.
Muda gani itachukua.
All those challenges.
Hiyo changamoto.
That you've been facing.
Ambao umekuwa ukipitia.
It doesn't care.
Haijalishi.
How might they have lasted.
Vile imekaa.
There is one of us.
Kuna moja wetu.
Who passed through.
Ambaye alipitia.
And we believe in him.
Na tunamuamini yeye.
That if he makes.
Ya kwamba kama aliweza.
Also has.
Hata nasi.
We are going to pass through.
Tutayapitia.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Katika jina la Yesu.
We
Christo.
Don't see what is happening now.
Hatuoni kile kinatendeka sasa.
But we see, we behold him.
Lakini tunamtazama yeye.
We look unto him.
Tunamtazama yeye.
Steadfastly.
Tukiwa na bidii.
Praise be the name of the Lord.
Jina la Bwana lipewe sifa.
Am I talking to somebody in this church?
Yeye ninamuongelesha mtu katika kanisa hili.
Listen.
Skiza.
He ate food.
Alikula chakula.
Like us.
Kama sisi.
He got angry.
Alikuwa na njaa.
Like us.
Kama sisi.
He was resisted.
Alipingwa.
Like us.
Kama sisi.
But he became.
Lakini akafanyika.
The high priest.
Kuhani mkuu.
Because the Bible says clearly.
Kwa sababu Biblia inasema kwa wazi.
But in the tabernacle in wilderness.
Ya kwamba katika hekalu kule jangwani.
Aaron used to went to the tabernacle.
Aaron alikuwa anaingia kwenye hekalu ama hema ya kutana.
Once a year.
Mara moja kwa mwaka.
And he was going there.
Na alikuwa anaingia pale.
To plead for his cause.
Kuweza kuomba msamaha kwa mambo.
And sanctifies himself.
Na kujitakaza.
Before he over sacrifices for other men.
Kabla ya kutoa dhabihu ya watu wengine.
He was supposed. Or it was a must.
Ilikuwa ni lazima.
It was a regulation.
Ilikuwa ni kanuni.
For him also.
Kwake pia.
To present his weakness.
Kuwakilisha udhaifu wake.
And to repent.
Na kutubu.
Before he entered to the Holy of Holies.
kabla ya kuingia patakatifu pa patakatifu.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
Jesus like Aaron,
Yesu kama Aruni,
he came to the world,
alikuja ulimwenguni,
and he became the high priest,
na akafanyika kuhani mkuu,
and he took our sins,
na akachukua dhambi zetu,
and he became a sinner,
na akakuwa mwenye dhambi,
on our behalf,
kwa ajili yetu,
and he went,
na akaenda,
not to the tent,
sio kwenye hema,
not to the sanctuary of the world,
sio katika,
but he went to the heavenly places,
hekalu ya dunia, lakini mahali
presenting
pa mbingu,
our weakness,
akichukua udhaifu
wetu, and he went there once and for all,
na akilienda pale mara moja na
mwisho, and he stayed forever,
na ako pale milele,
seated at the right side of the Father,
akiketi kwenye mkono wa kuume wa
Baba, interceding always,
akituombea kila wakati,
for the saints in the world,
kwa wapendwa walioko duniani,
beholding the face of the Father,
akitazama uso wa Baba,
speaking on our behalf,
akinena kwa niaba yetu,
praying for us,
akituombea sisi,
pleading with the God,
akiomba Mungu,
asking Father,
akimuomba Bwana,
forgive them,
uwasamehe,
I have paid the price,
nimelipa gharama,
for Sister Lois,
kwa dada Lois,
I have paid the price,
nimelipa gharama,
for Sister Nancy,
kwa dada Nancy,
I have paid the price,
nimelipa gharama,
for Brother Andrew,
kwa ndugu Andrew,
Father, forgive them,
Baba, uwasamehe,
I take all the price,
ninachu, nimelipa
at the cross of Calvary,
kwenye msalaba,
I paid the dues,
nimelipa deni yote. Hallelujah.
The Bible says,
Biblia inasema,
let us all fast on our confession.
Tushike sana maungamano yetu.
Since we had confessed,
kwa sababu tumekiri,
that Jesus is Lord,
ya kwamba Yesu ni Bwana,
Jesus is going to save me,
Yesu anaenda kuniokoa,
Jesus is going to liberate my life,
Yesu anaenda kuweka huru maisha
yangu. All fast to that confession.
Ukashikilie sana maungamano hayo.
Don't give up.
Usikate tamaa.
Don't give up.
Usikate tamaa.
Even what the pressure is telling you.
Hata kama ile sindikisho inakwambia.
If the surroundings tells you.
Kama mazingira inakwambia.
That you need to leave that convention.
Ya kwamba uache hiyo maungamano.
Hold it fast.
Ushikilie sana.
Even if troubles are forcing you.
Hata kama shida zinakulazimisha.
To renounce your convention.
Uweze kuacha.
Hold it fast.
Ushikilie sana.
Even if the curses are very strong in the family.
Hata kama laana zina nguvu kwenye familia.
Hold it fast.
Ushikilie sana.
You confess.
Unakiri.
It was not in vain.
Haikuwa bure.
Your convention was not in vain.
Haikuwa bure.
Hold it fast.
Ushikilie sana.
I said from the word God.
Nilisema tangia mwanzo.
Tell the devil.
Mwambie shetani.
I said from the word God.
Nilisema tangia mwanzo.
That my Jesus.
Ya kwamba Yesu wangu.
Is gonna redeem my life.
Anaenda kukomboa maisha yangu.
My Jesus.
Yesu wangu.
Is gonna heal my sicknesses.
Anaenda kuniponya magonjwa.
My Jesus.
Yesu
wangu. Is gonna cure my diseases.
Hold
fast to that convention. Don't give up, my friend. Don't give up, my sister. Don't give up, my father. Hold fast to that convention. Devil is a liar. Your father is alive.
Hey!
Sometimes things happen.
Wakati mwingine mambo hutendeka.
But you feel so weak.
Ama unahisi mdhaifu sana.
You became less even to go to pray.
Unakuwa hata una nguvu ya kwenda kwa
maombi. You feel you've prayed for something.
Unahisi umeombea kitu.
And seem there is no change.
Na inaonekana hakuna mabadiliko.
But the Bible says here.
Na Biblia inasema hapa.
The priest.
Kuhani.
Has already passed through the heavens.
Tayari amepitia mbingu.
He is standing at the presence of the Father.
Anasimama uweponi mwa Baba.
He is about to speak about your issues.
Ako karibu kunena
so kuhusu. Hold fast to your faith, and hold fast to your confession, because that priest who is sent for us, he has already entered through the heavens, and he is standing at the sanctuary in the heavenly places. Somebody say thank you, Jesus. Can someone say thank you, Jesus? Hey, thank you, Jesus. Oh Lord, thank you, Jesus. Can someone say thank you, Jesus? Can someone say thank you, Lord?
Oh, Lord.
Oh, hey.
Hallelujah.
Let me assure you.
Wachani kuhakikishie.
Be seated a moment, please.
Keti kidogo tafadhali.
Let me assure you.
Wachani kuhakikishie.
That we have no doubt.
Ya kwamba hatuna shaka.
That he went there.
Ya kwamba alienda pale.
When the children of Israel.
Wakati wana wa Israeli.
Faced some challenges.
Walipokuwa na changamoto.
They over sacrificed.
Walikuwa natoa dhabihu.
And they commit to Aaron.
Na walikuwa naweka kwa Aroni.
They commit to Aaron.
Walikuwa naweka kwa Aroni.
And Aaron received their sacrifices.
Na Aroni alikuwa anapokea dhabihu.
And he was only legally allowed to enter into the Holy of Holies to present the petitions of the children of Israel. So the children of Israel, they were waiting outside the tent, but Aaron alone was going to meet with God to talk to God about the issues of the people outside. The people outside were expecting Aaron to come out to tell them good news. But God has spoken. What you have prayed for, God has answered. What you anticipate for, God has declared it will happen. And the children of Israel, they will start celebrating. God, they did not go inside, but they will celebrate because Aaron went inside and spoke to the Father and came outside with a report. Somebody say yes. We have one priest. We have one priest by the name Jesus who passed through the heavens and went to the sanctuary and stood before the Father pleading for our causes, praying for you, praying for you, pleading for your children, pleading for the church. I don't cry anymore. I don't complain anymore. There is a priest who has went in. He's gone in. It's inside. He took my issues. I'm waiting for him. I'm holding in my confession. I hold tight what I confess. I'm holding tight. I'm not changing. I'm not tuning my face. I cannot change. I cannot change. I cannot be changed by the current problems. I cannot be changed by the country economy. I confess that Jesus is Lord, and I am holding to that confession. I hold it fast. Sita wachilia nilikiri yeye ni Bwana, bado yeye ni Bwana. Watoto ni wagonjwa, bado yeye ni Bwana. Sina chakula, bado yeye ni Bwana. Watoto wangu wako na shida, bado yeye ni Bwana. I've just remembered that day.
Nimekumbuka siku ile.
The first day.
Siku ya kwanza.
I was told.
Niliambiwa.
That is good.
Ya kwamba yeye ni mwema.
He's merciful.
Yeye ni wa rehema.
He's a life-giving God.
Ni Mungu anapeana uzima.
He's God who gave chance.
Ni Mungu ambaye anapeana
fursa. He's God who forgives.
Ni Mungu wa msamaha.
He's God who heals.
Ni Mungu anayeponya.
I remember that day.
Nikakumbuka siku hiyo.
I accepted.
Nikakubali.
For those testimonies.
Kwa ushuhuda hizo.
That Jesus is Lord.
Ya kwamba Yesu ni Bwana.
I am holding.
Ninashikilia.
To those conventions. I confess that time that I accept with all my heart Jesus to be my Lord, to be the Lord of my life. I cannot change now. What I face today will not change my faith. What I face today will not take me away. Ninazo nipata sasa aita nitoa. Ninazo pitia sasa aita nitoa kwake. Ninazo tazama sasa aita nitoa kwake. Njaa ya watoto wangu aita nitoa kwake.